more time. Jesus, I believe in you.
Thank you. to lift up his name, sing of his greatness.
Thank you.
Shall we pray? Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. We thank you that we can come into your presence and call you our Father.
Amen.
This morning, as we sing your praise and listen to your word, we pray that you would help us to really know you, so that we may worship you for all your works and for all that shines forth from them, your almighty power, wisdom, kindness, justice, mercy, and truth. By your Holy Spirit, we ask that you would direct our lives, all that we think, say, and do, so that your name would never be dishonored because of us, but always honored and praised. Your kingdom come. Rule us by your word and spirit, so that we submit to you more and more. We ask that you would strengthen this church and deepen our faith, so that we may be living signs of your coming kingdom. Equip us to be your witnesses here at Seoul National University and wherever we go in the future. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. When we look at the world around us and we see violence and injustice, we know that this is not your will. We pray for the people on earth, Lord, that you would move their hearts with compassion and love.
Yeah.
We pray that they would not seek to harm one another or your creation, but follow paths of peace. We ask that you would make us instruments of your peace and show us how to seek your will in our different academic fields. Give us this day our daily bread. We thank you, Lord, for your many gifts, for the sun and the rain and the turning of the seasons. We thank you for providing for our needs. Lord, help us not to be greedy, but to share our time, our talents, and our resources with those who have less. Forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. We recognize that we cannot free ourselves from sin. Only you, by the power of the blood of Christ, can make us pure and whole. It is because of your graciousness that we have the capacity to reconcile with our neighbors.
Amen.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Though the devil, the world, and the desires of the flesh do not stop their attack, we pray that you would make us strong for this spiritual battle. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. We pray all this to you because we know that in your goodness, you listen to our prayers, and in your power, you are able to answer them. In the holy name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
And this is the word of God, Psalms 27. We'll be reading from verse 1 to 4, and I ask that as we read it together, I pray this word, you would read it slowly and let it roll over your heart. This is the word of God. Let us read together. The Lord is my light and my salvation, and whom shall I fear? And the Lord is the stronghold of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? And when evildoers assail me to eat up my flesh, my adversaries and foes, it is they who stumble and fall. And though an army encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. And though war rise against me, yet I will be confident. One thing have I asked of the Lord, and that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. This is the word of the Lord. Praise be to God. You may be seated. I'd like to open us up just to invite the Lord in this portion of our service in prayer. Just before we start, there's a lot of people here today, and we didn't get to do it already. Maybe just say someone next to you. Shalom. Welcome. Thank you for being here at church today. We're so happy to see you. God bless you guys. When was the last time we had this many people at church? Wow, this is amazing. It's been a very long time. I see some new faces. I see some old faces. I see some faces that have just come out of the army. Our brother just came out of the army. Welcome. We are so happy you are here. God bless you guys all here today. The title of the sermon today is You Are My One Thing. And it is once again, as it always has been, truly an honor to share with all of you the heart of God through His Word. Throughout the past 8 months of having the privilege of being here at SNU campus and sharing my life with all of you, as well as you sharing your life with me too, being able to walk with you all in very different capacities, it has brought praise and wonder to my heart, the different sides of God's images that I get to see through all of you. And I just want to give glory to God for the privilege to know you amazing men and women of God, to serve you in this season of your life, and to be able to build His kingdom together. I especially want to thank my worship team, Elaine and Tamara and Sana Komo, Swan, wherever you are, Swan, wherever Swan, and Camilo and Yomosem. They serve week in and week out. They prepare services. Even when Elaine is sick, she will come and lead worship. And so can we just give a round of applause to Elaine for leading worship today? I want to honor them when I have the time. I want to start by asking all of you the very important question today. Who is God to you? And let that question begin to dwell in your mind, not who God is to the person next to you. Us are like a thief, and they will do whatever they can to try to kill, steal, and destroy your joy, as it says in John 10:10. That is why God gives to His people the power of worship and prayer, to declare the truth and to not. You see, that is why God gives to His people the power of worship and prayer, to declare the truth and to not look to the circumstances within themselves or around them, but to look straight ahead to who He truly is. I pray the eyes of your heart today will see. See, verse 2 says, when evildoers assail me to eat up my flesh, my adversaries and foes, it is they who stumble and fall. And though an army encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. And though war rise against me, yet I will be confident. See, many of us here today can probably relate to these external situations that David must have been feeling in verse 2 and 3. It feels like there were just evil people out to get you. I know for someone in here today that your thesis advisor, for no warrant reason, just harbors evil against you. Your professors, or maybe your classmates, as I've heard, or maybe it's even your family members, seems to have the most evil malintent towards you. Brothers and sisters, remember the final words that Jesus said as He commissioned His disciples in Matthew 28:20, and behold, I am with you always, the end of the age. In every situation that you are walking through right now, every trial and difficulty, let this be a comfort to you today, that He who is the most powerful, the most brilliant, the most loving and kind, He is on your side. He holds your hand in the midst of every circumstance. I am here with you. When you mourn, He mourns with you. When you feel wronged, He feels the unfairness with you. His heart of compassion draws near to you, just as Jesus' heart was moved within Him for the leper in Mark 1:41. His heart is not far from mine, but is right by your side. And He who began a good work in your life will finish what He started. Read what Moses said to the Israelites in his final moments on this earth in Deuteronomy 31:6. Be strong and courageous. Do not fear or be in dread of them. It's the pagan worshippers of the foreign nations. For it is the Lord your God who goes with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Fear not the situations that envelop you or to those who come against you, for God will protect his righteous beloved. That is why Jesus says, do not repay evil for evil, for justice belongs to the Lord.